Hey leaders, welcome to a new year and welcome to another episode of The Debrief. This is that time of year where many of you are making goals and resolutions, and I think that's awesome. But let me encourage you, while you're making those other goals and resolutions, whether that's to eat healthier or work out more or pay down debt or whatever your other goals may be, let me encourage you to make the absolute most important resolution you can make in 2020. My thoughts for today are going to be coming from this book that we've been reading as a team called The Emotionally Healthy Leader by Pete Scazzaro. And in fact, all of our episodes this season on The Debrief are going to be coming from our team members sharing what the Lord has been teaching them through this book. You know, at FaithBridge, we talk a lot about the concept of overflow. And that means to be a healthy and thriving leader that's leading a healthy and thriving group, it's only going to come out of the overflow of the vitality of your own personal spiritual life with Jesus. And sadly, an element that many of us are missing in our discipleship is the sanctification of our emotional lives. And that wreaks havoc not only in our lives, but it wreaks havoc in the lives of those that we love and lead. Because as Scazzaro says in the opening pages of his book, it is not possible to be spiritually mature while remaining emotionally immature. And one of the main reasons why we find ourselves in a place of emotional unhealth, especially for those of us in leadership, is that we find ourselves engaging in more activity for God than our being with God can sustain. So in order to be healthy and thriving leaders, we have to develop what Scazzaro calls a slowed down spirituality. And if you're like me, that does not come naturally, because by nature, I'm a doer. But if we are going to be effective in our ministry, we have to learn to be before we do. And in fact, we see this modeled in the life of Jesus. As Scazzaro says, in the first 30 years of his life, Jesus did nothing extraordinary. Nonetheless, before his public ministry began, the Father said to him, "You are my Son, whom I love. With you, I am well pleased." You see that? God the Father was pleased in the Son because of who he was before he did anything. So likewise, in 2020, let me encourage you to resolve to be, to resolve to be with God. Let me share with you one way that I'm doing that in my personal spiritual life this year. My morning time with God is something that has been a consistent part of my life for years now. But if I'm honest, even as someone who works in full-time ministry, I'm not very good at staying connected with God throughout the day. So one of my resolutions this year is what I'm calling my midday check-in with God. And I usually do this either over lunch or when I've just returned from a lunch appointment. And essentially, this looks like three steps. First, I reflect on what has happened in my day so far and how that has made me feel. Second, I set my eyes on the truths of the gospel using the daily reading from this devotional, New Morning Mercies by Paul David Tripp. And third, I spend a few minutes praying over the rest of my day's to-do list. And this whole process takes maybe 15 minutes, but that small investment of time makes a huge difference in my life and in my ministry. So in 2020, resolve to be with God. What is one practice or habit that you can resolve to do in 2020 that's going to help you be with God before ever doing anything for God? Perhaps you need to establish a weekly Sabbath rhythm, a weekly 24-hour period to simply rest and delight in God. Or perhaps you need to set aside a few minutes each day of silence and solitude. No agenda, no boxes to check, just to be with God. Maybe you actually need to read the Bible less this year. That way you can have time to reflect and meditate on the scripture that you're reading. Or perhaps like me, you need to establish a rhythm to check in with God during the day. Whatever you do, leaders, let me encourage you, be with God and enjoy Him. And then out of the overflow of your joy in Him, and only then, go out and do for Him, like leading your grow group.